We are looking at chapter number 3, Why Do We Need a Parliament? So the question comes, why do we need a parliament? That is Sansad. So Sansad is the parliament actually. We are in a democracy, that is Loktantra. Now there is always in democracy, the prime important or importance is the involvement of the people, that is the citizens. The elements that together make us democracy, and that is best expressed in the institution of the parliament. So we are going to talk about parliament today, how this parliament enables the citizens to be a part of decision making and control the government. So that is why this is the symbol, a key feature of the constitution. Here we see in this picture, we have different people of different caste, creed, religion, and they are shown here just to say that everyone is involved in this building, and this is just a structure, but inside this there are people whom we have elected. Here is a person who is looking at the EVM, reader reading instruction for using the EVM. So from 2004 onwards, we have started, means Indians or India has started using EVMs. So we have saved around 1,50,000 trees, that is 8,000 tons of paper for printing ballot papers. Now we have just curtailed that. So we got independence on 15th August 1947, and there was a long freedom struggle. Everyone participated. The ideas were of freedom, equality and participation in decision making was there because everyone was involved. So everyone was thinking that we need to have a certain kind of society, we need to have certain kind of country. The nationalists began to openly criticize the British government at that time, and 1885 the Indian National Congress INC demanded for elected members in the legislature. This is the point where everything started. That is, they need the right to discuss the budget and ask questions. So the Government of India Act 1909 allowed for some elected representation, but this was early legislature under the British government. But they were in response just of the growing demands of the nationalists. But they didn't allow everyone to vote. That is, the participation was not whole. Only few adults were allowed to vote. So what we have experiences in the past under the colonial rule, but with the coming of independence, we are going to be the citizens of a free country. That is, that we need certain demands, we have certain needs. And these aspirations of or dreams of the people who fought the struggle, freedom struggle. So Constitution of Independent India, that laid down the principle of universal adult franchise, as we saw that previously it was there, but it was just on the pressure, because of pressure, and not all adults were allowed to vote. But here, after the constitution was made, universal adult franchise, that is all adult citizens of the country have the right to vote. Everyone who is 18 plus, regardless of what caste, creed, religion, anything, everyone has the right to vote. Here you see a person, or you can say election officer, he is going to a very remote area to for the elections. These are the electric voting machine he is carrying. So people, how we take the consent of the people, that is the approval, desire, participation of people, how do we ensure it? In a democratic government, it is all about people. So how we can just combine the ideas, or the you can say that everyone has to have some authority or some involvement in the government. So we need to have the principle of government and also the public institution that the citizens can understand, because they understand that this is because of us. So one way to do this is, everyone, we are crores now. We are around 132 crores right now. But at that time, we were, in crores. So everyone cannot just make decisions. So we have to elect certain representative that, okay, on behalf of us, these people are going to make decisions. So people would elect their representative to the parliament. Then one group from among these elected representatives, this forms the government. And then comes the parliament. Parliament is just not the house, that just not the building. It is made up of all representatives together. They control, they guide the government. That is, the people who have chosen their representative, they form the government and they also control it. So this is the idea where people are directly involved. This is the, let me just explain you this picture. So this is our parliament. The Parliament of India, which is called the Sanskrit, is the supreme law-making institution. So it has two houses, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha is the, this is the Council of States. That is, it has total strength of 245 and it is chaired by the Vice President of India. This is the Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha is, this is the Lok Sabha, House of People, with the total membership of 545, is presided over by the Speaker. So let me tell you again that we have a Parliament, then we have in the Parliament, we have the Rajya Sabha, and here we have Lok Sabha. So Lok Sabha is the lower house, Rajya Sabha is the upper house. Rajya Sabha, especially the elected members or nominated members, comes from the state legislature. Here we elect them directly, like MPs. These are member, all are member of parliament, are Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, they both are called as member of parliament. But here we elect them as MPs. Here they come from the state. So we have 245 strength of Rajya Sabha and 545 strength of Lok Sabha. In this, 12 members plus this 245 minus 12, that is, this means subtracted. So you get 243. So 243 are, they come from the state legislature or nominated by state legislature, and 12 are nominated by the president himself. And here 545, we have 543 MPs elected from all the constituencies, and 2 are nominated. So this is how the formation is. The Lok Sabha members are elected for 5-year term, and the Rajya Sabha, they are also five-year term, but 1/3 of the members, they retire. They retire every year like this. So what is the role of the government? Because it was created after 1947. The parliament is an expression of the faith of people of India. They have in principle of democracy. So they have a participation in the decision-making process of government by consent. So parliament has immense power because it is actually people. It is representing the people. So election of the parliament is held similar to what is happening in the state legislature. We elect the vidhayaks, and vidhayak form a government, or they make a CM, chief minister of a state. So Lok Sabha is elected for 5 years. So country is divided into numerous constituencies dependent on the area and the people, that is the population. So each of these constituency elect one person, parliament, we call them as a member of parliament. And the candidate who contest election, usually they come from different political parties. So here is an example of 2014 result. Now in this 2014 result, these are national party, these are state parties, all from here to here. Now Bharatiya Janata Party got 282 votes, means 282 MPs. Indian National Congress, 44, it was 200 plus in 2009 election, but 200 plus in 2009 election, but in 2014, because of, Narendra Modi ji and, the policies he introduced or he wanted to introduce, people, believed him, and he got the vote, he got the MPs because of him. Bharatiya Janata Party had a landslide victory. And 2019 also, Bharatiya Janata Party got around 303 plus MPs, only BJP. And if you take NDA, that is the NDA, the alliance of BJP and other different parties, they got more than 340 plus. So So here you see, this is the 2009 election. As I said, Indian National Congress got 206, BJP got 116. That is, here to this Indian National Congress in 2009, they made a UPA, that was also alliance, and they formed the government. So the government, what happens here is, once elected, these candidates become member of parliament, and these MPs, they together make the parliament. Okay. So to select the national government, what happens? As we just saw, what is the result here? Parliament of India consists of Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha. After Lok Sabha election, a list is prepared. MP belonging to each political party, which is in the majority of elected MPs. Like if you see, 543 are elected plus 2 Anglo-Indian nominated. 2 are nominated, which are Anglo-Indian. So 543 plus 2 becomes 545. Now they need to have a majority. So you see, this 272 number is a magic number. So if any party achieve this number in terms of MPs, then they are going to make the Sarkar, or they are going to form the government. So the opposition in parliament is formed by all the parties which are not in the government. So the largest among this party is called the opposition party. So we have the say government, and then we have opposition. And one of the most important function of this Lok Sabha is to select the executive. Who are executive? Now, this parliament is going to make the rules, regulations and law. And who is going to execute them? The executive. So executive are the person who work together to implement the laws which are made by the parliament. And this executive is often selected by, or is often what we have in mind when we use the term government. Then we have Prime Minister of India. This is the leader of those who have majority of more than 272. They elect a person or MP who is among them and who is the best one, they're supposed to be. So the MPs who belong to this party, the Prime Minister selects him. Once the Prime Minister has been elected by all these members, then now Prime Minister select the head of the different ministries, like Health Minister, Education Minister, Finance Minister, and these are MPs only. Now it may happen that the political party may not get 272. Say this Indian National Congress got 206. So in order to achieve 272, they make alliance. They may go with this party, and other parties, so that the numbers are more than 272. So this is how we call it this as the coalition government. So UPA and NDA, these are coalition government. So these are the two buildings, if you see this. So these are the two buildings, the South Block and the North Block. They were built in 1930s. So the photo on the left is of South Block, which houses the PMO, Prime Minister Office, Minister of Defense and Ministry of External Affairs. If you go to North Block, this is on the right, you see Ministry of Finance is there, Ministry of Home Affairs is there, and there are other ministries also in various parts of Delhi. So Rajya Sabha functions. Now Rajya Sabha function is because the people or the parliamentarian here are the state representatives. So they come from the state of India in the parliament. So the Rajya Sabha now can also initiate legislation or a bill required to pass through. So Lok Sabha, the law goes from here to Rajya Sabha, and that is why it is called the upper house. It has to pass through Rajya Sabha, then only it will become a law. Otherwise, it will not become. So what is the role of Rajya Sabha? Of reviewing and altering, if alterations are needed, that is Sanshodhan of laws initiated by the Lok Sabha. So the member of Rajya Sabha, they are elected by the elected members of Legislative Assembly. Who comes in Rajya Sabha? The members elected from legislative assemblies of different states. So there are 233 elected members plus 12, as I said, nominated by the president. So the basic idea is to control, guide and inform the government. So the parliament starts with a question hour. Every day we have a question hour, that is 1 hour for question. Now in this question hour, say this is opposition, this is government. Opposition asks questions from the government, and specific minister are being asked, like what happened to this and what are you doing this. So there are point wise questions, and the government has to answer it. The minister has to answer it And this is the duty of the MPs to ask the question regarding or pertaining the citizen. So this is a very crucial task. This is very important for healthy functioning of the democracy. And these MPs, they highlight the drawbacks of various policies and programs of the government and also mobilize the popular support of their own politics. So the government gets feedback also once this question hour is going on and opposition is asking, or any MP is asking to the government or government ministry, then there is a valuable feedback it is getting. And also government are kept on toes by the question asked by the MPs. And along with this, the matter dealing with finances, the parliament approval is crucial for the government. The parliament cannot just make any law. It has to have passed through all the MPs. They have to say, means yes or no. So this is how the parliament controls, guides and informs the government. Parliament controls, guides and informs the government. So the MP is representative of the people. They have very central role in controlling, guiding and informing the parliament. And that is the key aspect of the Indian democracy. So the next thing is lawmaking. Lawmaking is, we'll discuss about all this, but the main idea is parliament makes the law. It is the lawmaking, you can say authority. So who are the people in parliament? They can come from anywhere. Parliament, the people or the MPs are coming from different background. They are mainly from some, related to some parties, but there are more rural members as also the members from many regional parties. So there are certain people who are now, previously they were unrepresented, but we have seen the increase in political participation from Dalits and backwards. So you just see that how they have increased. This is the population who voted. So in first Lok Sabha, 61.16, that is around 61 people among 100 people in our country, they voted. And in 16 Lok Sabha, 66.400 has voted. So this is how interest and experience separate us in important to, in order to ensure the communities that have the marginalization in the historic background. So with this mind, one thing is very important, that the parliament, that there has to be seats which are to be reserved. And this has been done so that the MPs elected from these constituencies, they are familiar with, and they can represent the Dalit and Adivasi's interest in the parliament also. So there is a proper reservation. There are the constituencies. There are constituencies reserved for SCs, STs. So we have also seen that there are seats. There is a mang, or there is a requirement, or people are talking about reservations of women. Because see, in any country, 50% of the, around 50% of the population is women. And we just have, say, 4 women in the first Lok Sabha. Now we have 9 women only. So this is very less amount of representation by the female. So this is still an issue which are debated, and maybe in coming years we'll get a law of 33% reservation for women. So there are certain unresolved questions, as this one is there, and there are various others. And people, we have this thought, and we have faith, and people have faith in the democratic form of government, that everything like this will come into play. So there are certain words like approval, to give one consent or two and be favorable towards something. In coalition means temporary alliance of group of parties in order to form a government. Like I said, UPA and NDA. So if say in NDA, the BJP got only, say, I'm just giving an example, 250 seats. And they need 272. So they'll they have already alliance with Shiv Sena and various other parties like JDU. And they make, along with this Shiv Sena and JDU, they will be way ahead of 272. Now they can form the government. The UPA has some other, Janata Dal in Karnataka. So if they have, say, 220 seats, so they can combine with others to make a coalition. This is coalition government. Then we have unresolved. So unresolved means situation in which there are no easy solution to problem, like the women reservation bill. Now, what happened, the Biju Janata Dal, they actually gave in 2019 33% seats, and the Mamata government, that is the Trinamool Congress, they give 33% reservation, or not just any law is there, but this, they just gave tickets to women, 33% seats to women. So that is how things will, you know, go, and this unresolved will be resolved somewhere in coming future. So this is all about this topic. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.